Hello everyone, my name is Hadil and today we're doing part two of these random cubes tutorial. So I've done the mesh part and in this tutorial we'll do animation and materials. And I also figured out how to do the rotation after the mesh is created. So we did set the origin to the cursor, the origin of all of the cubes to the cursor so we can rotate the whole thing, but we rotated these cubes manually, but today we're gonna do the script way or the Python way of doing it. Okay, let's start. First, we'll do the rotation because usually when we're creating in 3D, we create the mesh and then I position it in wherever place I want it to be and then scale it and then finally rotate it if I need to. So in order to do that, I'm going to have to get the object, the selected object. And naturally, when you add a cube to Blender or to the viewport, then it is selected. So I'm going to just get the active object. And we can do that by using the BPy library that we've imported previously. And I stored it in a variable called obj, just for object. And then I'm going to go into the context module and finally get the active. Now when this is created, it is the active object. So I'm just grabbing that. And then I'll do whatever I want to do. Go to edit, do the beveling, and then go back into object mode, and after just setting the origin, we'll do the rotation. So the rotation is going to go through this object. We're going to say rotation underscore. And I think if you go over here to rotation and you hover over it, you can see that it says whatever the object is, and then it goes into rotation Euler. So this is exactly what I'm doing, but then I'm setting it to a value. And it takes in an array of three values, x, y, and z, of course. So we'll do these three values. And it is also why I did import the math module, because we haven't used it yet, but we're using it right now. So what I'm doing over here is converting degrees into radians, because this only accepts radians, but you can also use math.py and divide and multiply however you like. So let's say you want a full rotation, then just do math.py multiply by 2, and that will give you a full rotation. And we'll do that later when we do the animation. But for this one, I'm just grabbing whatever values we already inputted into these. So -8.7. And then 1.97, negative as well, and then 45.5. If I run this right now, it should give me the same look that we have. But I mean, because randomizing the size and the location of these cubes, it's not going to look exactly the same. But the whole rotation of it is going to look kind of similar. Okay, now let's run it and see what happens. See, it has the same angle of rotation. Now let's create an animation, which is really fun. It's simply rotating this whole thing, kind of like doing it like, so it's kind of like grabbing all of this and then rotating it on the z-axis, a full rotation. We're not doing anything complex here. And we're also going to use this active object. So everything is happening still inside of the for loop. Okay, so how you can do this is by using the object again and then keyframe insert. And then you give it a data path. That will be rotation Euler and frame number. So we'll start at 1. I think you can do 0, but you'll have to change the timeline from 0. I've always kept it to the default, so we're just going to do 1. And then we do the rotation with the changes that we want. So this one is going to create, or this one is going to create a keyframe for this line of code. And then, so let's actually remove the space in between. And then this one is going to be another rotation. And then we're going to add keyframe afterward to set it in. So this will be, let's say, frame 120. And if I go back to layout, I'll just do 120 for this one, just to limit it. And then I'll go back to scripting. And this is what I meant by saying we can then add math.py multiplied by 2. So I added a full rotation to our Z index. Now if I, the error is that data path has an underscore. Now I have this. So if I hit space, when I hover over here, we get the animation. But you can see that the interpolation is not linear, and I want it to be linear, especially with looping animation. You don't want any easing in or out, because then it'll disrupt the full rotation of something or the loop that you're trying to create. And if I go over here and I select these two and then right click and I go into interpolation mode, I can see that I think this is Bezier, I think it's the default, but there is linear and there is constant. Constant is not going to do anything. It's basically going to jump from one movement to the other, but linear is what we want. And if you look at it, it says bpy.obs.action.interpolation_type, and then the type is going to be linear. We're going to have to select all of the keyframes that we've created. And there's a way to find out where things are or how to access certain things. It is by going to the data API. And if I go over here and I go into objects and then I go into one of the cubes, I can find the path to my keyframes. So I have to go to animation. Okay, so here's animation data. And then I go into action, and then I go into F curves and keyframes, and those are the keyframes that we have. So this is another way to help you understand what object has. So what parts of the object you can change, or what parts of the object you can target. But I don't necessarily use these, or I haven't used them yet. But it helps to understand where things are. So if I didn't see this, I wouldn't know it's inside of an F curve. Okay, so let's grab the F curves, because if we add the keyframes like this, we're adding it to all of these, and each one has a different F curve. So I have to go through all of the F curves, or technically we only need to go through the Z, but we'll go through it all. So F curves, and then I go into object, animation, data, and then where did we go? And then action, and finally F curves. So now we have the list of curves. And then in a for loop, I'll go F curve in F curves that we just created, or we just grabbed. I'm gonna go for keyframe in F curve dot keyframe, and I think it's not keyframes. Yeah, it's keyframe points. Strangely, I don't know why, but that's how it is. And let's shorten this to KF. And now I can do the linear interpolation. So I'll just do KF dot interpolation equals linear, all caps. Okay, I made a mistake here. Now, if I run this, we should get the final animation correctly. So if I click over here, we have a linear interpolation. It looks like it's looping forever, even though we only have 120 frames. And now, finally, the materials. So let's stop this. For the materials, you're going to have to go into materials and create a list of materials. So if I go to shading, so let's go to layout because I've created this for shading. Actually, before we do that, if you look over here, you can see the bevel lines. And if I click on it and do shade smooth, we get a better look, right, of the cube. So we're going to do that first, and then we'll get to the materials, because I figured that out as well. So after I do the beveling, if I go into the objects operator, I can just do shade smooth, and it should shade it smooth. So if I don't do this one and then I run it, you can see the ridges over here, but it's much better if you do smooth shading. Now let's get to the materials. So if I go to layout and I do, we already have materials that I've created before, but let's create just colorful materials. I have a picture that I'm going to add over here in the image editor. Okay, I have my colors, and now let's create new materials. Just simple materials. I'll go into scripting. Let's go back to Blender file. I want to delete the other materials that I've created. So these four, I want to change one thing. Instead of calling this dark green, I'm going to call it green. And then for one reason, because I want to get or to grab all the colors from here down to here. And I'm 100% sure there's a better way of doing this, but humor me for now. Okay, let's grab a random material and we'll store it in a variable called matte or whatever. And this will go to bpy.data.materials. And because it's called materials, generally that means it's a list. So we'll grab whatever value. So let's say I have, or I want to grab the first color that I have, or green. So that's going to be 2, as in 0, 1, 2. And let's give all of the objects the same material. Let's go into EV so you can see colors. So this is grabbing all of the materials inside of your file, but then you can go into object. So this is our active object at the moment. And then dot data dot materials. So this is the materials for this object. And this is looking for slots over here. But if we're adding the objects, we still don't have any slots for any of them. This happened to have one. So if I click on this one, it doesn't have any slots. And for that, you're going to have to append one. And that's where you're going to append your own material. So if I run this, we should have the green material. Now, I don't want to have that. I want to get a random color from the third material over here to the last one. And that's when we're going to use the random integer, because we cannot really use uniform. We need integers. So rand int. And then it's going to go from 2 to materials.length, or one less than the materials length. So if I go leng, this is how you get the length in Python of a list. And then you do bpy.data.materials. And then outside of that length, I'm going to say -1, because I have to subtract 1 from the length, since the indices start from 0. That means that the last one is going to be 1 less than the length. And if I look into cycles, it'll look much nicer. And we can do different ones. Now, there's a better way to do this, as I found on Stack Overflow, which is the best place to find lines of code or help. Okay, so what if you want to create the cubes, but you don't want to remove everything and then recreate it all over again, like I'm doing over here? But you might want the materials to change every time. So yeah, you can do a script, create the mesh, and then create a new script where you can add your materials. So sometimes you might have a material already or a material slot for each one of them. So you'll have to check if the object has materials already or has a slot, then you'll have to just change the material in that slot instead of appending another slot, because then it's not going to grab the materials from there. So for that, we're going to have to check if materials exist for the object. And we can use an if conditional. So if object.data.materials is just a thing, if it doesn't have anything, then it's nil and it's going to give you false. But then for else, we're going to do this. So if there is any materials like we have right now, then I want you to change the first slot to our current material that we've chosen over here. Otherwise, you're going to have to append a new material. But for our script, we're not going to need this that much because we're recreating the cubes over and over again. So we're resetting the slots for each of the cubes because we're deleting the older cubes anyway. So if I run this over and over again, now we have a new material. So it didn't really change anything. And then if I hover over here and hit the space bar, then I get the animation. And you get to see the whole cube. That's pretty much what I have for you today. It's much easier than the first tutorial, just because in the first tutorial, we're kind of establishing the whole premise of what using Python in Blender is like. But in this tutorial, we're just finishing what we already started. And I hope that it all makes sense. If it didn't, you can ask questions in the comments. That's what it is for, at least in this channel. And if you have any requests for anything that you want me to learn or anything that you've seen me do in previous tutorial or on Instagram that you would like to know how I made, then please DM me on Instagram or comment down below, because I'd love to hear a suggestion. And I do add them. I do consider them for upcoming tutorials. I mean, I'm just one person, so my brain can get empty sometimes and it needs a little bit of a push to get new ideas. And let me know if you want to learn scripting in other programs like Illustrator and Photoshop, or if you want to learn scripting in After Effects, because I do that sometimes. Yeah, whatever generative art or whatever you can generate as a designer to facilitate whatever you're creating, I'm happy to learn, because I do learn that for myself anyway, just to make things much easier, faster. I mean, we already use plugins, right? And those are technically scripts that other people have created. Yeah, I'm gonna go and render my animation. And I hope to see your work on Instagram or Twitter. And it's now time for me to sign off, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye. Blue dude. Blue moon. Kinda mysterious, shaded by someone I'm not really into. Do you need to fix it? Talking bullshit.